This episode is brought to you by Dashlane. Dashlane makes it faster and easier to log into all your online accounts securely by safely storing and encrypting complex passwords. Go to dashlane.com/simplehistory or click the link in the description below to get Dashlane Premium and get 10% off for 1 year of Dashlane Premium with the discount code SIMPLEHISTORY. Petardier, suicidal job, late medieval to early Renaissance. Petardiers were special units of late medieval and early Renaissance armies. These explosive specialists were not engaged in open battles, but only during sieges where their skills were the most useful. Their task was to prepare and set up explosive charges to breach obstacles that were impenetrable to infantry units. Their targets were mainly fortress walls and city gates, but were also engaged against other impediments. These types of units first appeared in France in the late 16th century during the battles against Huguenot cities. Soon they appeared in armies across the whole of Europe and remained in service until the beginning of the 18th century, when they were replaced with more reliable artillery. The name petardier comes from petard, an explosive device they used to breach walls and gates. The weapon name was actually a funny nickname given by French soldiers, as the Middle French word for Peter means to break wind. A petard was a cylindrical or frusto-conical metal container filled with compacted gunpowder. The petard's size varied and was proportional to the resistance of the target object. Some of the preserved examples weigh as much as 100 pounds or 46 kilograms. They were made of different types of metal like bronze, copper, iron, or lead. Once loaded and sealed with wax, the petard was attached with this open end against the target surface. The open end was covered with a large wooden plank reinforced with iron plates. This addition served to spread the petard's blasting force over a larger area. Depending on the strength of the obstacle the petard was intended to destroy, there were many different ways to attach the petard. These included lag bolts, hooks, long iron forks, or even larger constructions. Besides his petard, a petardier was equipped with instruments such as a hammer, lag bolts, additional powder, fuses, flint and steel to ignite the primer, and other smaller auxiliary tools. Naturally, the petardier was not capable of carrying such a heavy load by himself. Therefore, one chief petardier was also accompanied by several assistant petardiers. They helped him carry the petard and tools, but were also armed with muskets to protect him from fortress defenders. Considering the nature of their job, petardiers wore special heavy armor. One such example found in Switzerland was used by a petardier in L'Escalade, the attempt of the Savoyan army to conquer the walls of the city of Geneva on December 11, 1602. This armor was much thicker than ordinary armor of infantrymen, with thickness varying from 0.2 to 0.38 inches, or 5 to 10 millimeters, and a total weight of 40 pounds or 18 kilograms. The armor was strong enough to protect the petardier from both enemy muskets and petard blasts. The helmet was of an even stronger design. It was 0.7 inches or 8 millimeters thick and 25 pounds or 11.4 kilograms. It had an inner lining and cheek protection. The petardier armor covered only the upper part of the body because they mainly received attacks from above. This design also allowed better leg mobility, which was of vital significance once the petard was ignited. Without armor on his legs, the petardier could run away quickly from the blast. It was obvious that the armor was a great burden for the petardier to carry. However, it was necessary since the petardier's duties had many dangers. Petardiers were exposed to enemy attacks. The weak spots that the petardiers targeted were often watched over by the best guards. Once the petardier appeared on site, he became a target for the enemy guards aware of the danger he was bringing. Even if the petardier managed to reach his target and set the fuse, this was not the end of his problems. Inadequate fuses or strayed powder often caused immediate explosions. Even if everything went as planned, the petardier could still be killed by the explosion if he wasn't fast enough to reach his cover. For this reason, the job of the petardier was not a popular one. A high percentage of petardiers didn't live long enough to become veterans of their jobs. Because of the many dangers of the job, William Shakespeare coined the expression, "hoist with his own petard." First used in the play Hamlet, it signifies when a person is harmed by their own plan to harm others, like how a petard bomb maker was blown up by their own bomb. Protect your digital identity from modern-day petardiers with today's sponsor. Dashlane makes it faster and easier to log into all your online accounts securely by safely storing and encrypting complex passwords. Don't waste time remembering passwords and details. With Dashlane, you can fill in forms fast with one-click logins and autofill for personal info and payment details. It works everywhere, on every device, across all platforms and operating systems. On top of this, the built-in VPN strengthens your security when browsing. Respond quickly to data breaches with personalized security alerts. Not even Dashlane can see your data. It's decrypted locally on your device. Shopping for that deal that's ending soon? Instantly log in and fill out addresses and payment details in just a click. Dashlane has 11 plus million users in 180 countries, and it's endorsed by the Wall Street Journal, New York Times, Fast Company, Forbes, Wired, and more. It's top-rated in the iOS App Store and is recommended by both Apple and Google. Go to dashlane.com/simplehistory or click the link in the description below to get Dashlane Premium and get 10% off for 1 year of Dashlane Premium with the discount code SIMPLEHISTORY.